Villagers unselfishly laboring to honor their most famous son, Moses Mauani Kotane, will finally rest among his people. Locals want his vision immortalized. To this end, they are proposing a Moses Kotane Museum and Library.
We intended, together with the government, that departments of arts and culture should try to build, should assist us in building the museum and also the library. And we intend doing some sort of hero's acre.
Earlier in the week, the local ANC branch hosted a memorial service here.
We have hope that some of our people or the stalwarts who went away in exiles, while some of us were not there, you can even see today that some of us were able to speak because of their contribution. So we are saying we want them, their remains, to be brought back to our province so that our children and those who will be born, they will be able to go to the graveyards and see.
For the family, this is a remarkable event.
It really hurts to hear that someone has died and you didn't bury him. So when you bury him yourself and know where his remains are, we will get closure.
A monument is expected to be built near Kotane's final resting place. Kotane was one of the giants of the liberation struggle. He served both the ANC and SACP. In 1978, he suffered a stroke and went to the USSR for treatment. He died in Russia and was buried there. Tsholofelo Mathibedi, SABC News, Phela, near Rustenburg.